X-Matches or players. Of course, the next match will be battle for third. It is going to be between Altai BC Kazakhstan and Back of Glass Thailand. But before that, the Asian Women's Club Volleyball Championship 2016 would like to thank its official TV partners, TV5 and SMM TV Thailand, its official hotel, the Crimson Hotel, the official VIP cars, BMW, and also like to thank PLDT Home Montana, A6, Mikasa, Senu, Nike, and Rixona, its technical suppliers, Photon, Modern Caterpillar, PricewaterhouseCoopers Inc., its official auditing firm, and its organizing partners, the Asian Volleyball Confederation, Larong Volleyball sa Pilipinas, the City of Binyan, at ang Philippine Superliga. Good luck to the rest of the teams.
Yeah. discover. It is within each other to forgive and make amends. If I had known then what I know now, I wouldn't have said what I said. I took the long road, thought I'd be better on my own. Sometimes what's right is wrong instead. Cause I was too young and I didn't understand.
We are heroes tonight. town to town, from London to Taiwan. I've been all around the globe trying to protect your soul.
Nobody sees, nobody knows. We are a secret, can't be exposed. That's how it is, that's how it goes. Far from the others, close to each other. In the daylight, when the sun is shining. On the late night, when the moon is blinding. In the plain sight, like stars in hiding. You and I hold on. Two and together forever, we'll never change. Two and together we'll never change. Nobody sees, nobody knows. We are a secret, can't be exposed. That's how it is, that's how it goes. Far from the others, close to each other. That's when we uncover, cover, cover. That's when we uncover, cover, cover.
On your shoulder, I can reach an endless sky. Feels like paradise. Put two and two together forever, we'll never change. Two and two together, we'll never change. Nobody sees, nobody knows. We are a secret, can't be exposed. That's how it is, that's how it goes. Far from the others, close to each other. That's when we uncover, cover, cover. That's when we uncover, cover, cover. We could build a universe right here. All the world could disappear. Wouldn't know.
I can't wait. Good afternoon, volleyball fans, and welcome to the Asian Women's Club Volleyball Championship 2016 Battle for Third. And before we begin our match, let us meet our officials to help officiate this match. Our first referee, Nahoko Watanabe from Japan. Our second referee, Chu Yute from Taipei. And now, let us meet the starting lineup for Altai VC Kazakhstan. Starting with number one, Haley Spellman. Number two, Sana Anarkolova. Number three, Olga Biryakova. Number nine, Irina Lukomskaya. Number 14, Alesha Safronova. Their libero, number four, Alia Sanikova. And coaching Altai VC Kazakhstan is coach Burhan Zabolat. Now, here is the starting lineup for Bangkok Glass Thailand. Starting with number five, team captain, Plumjit Ningkau. Number eight, Willavan Apineable. Number 10, Junarat Montrepila. Number 11, Ponpun Getbai. Number 16, Ashley Frazier. Number 20, Huawei Bingok. Their libero, number 15, Pikapon Shankiao. And of course, coaching Bangkok Glass Thailand is coach Pon Shen Yong. Good luck to both teams.
And the two teams and their starting lineups have been introduced. Your forecast, not naman who wins, but more of who has the edge going into this match, Chicky.
Well, the Kazakhs are taller, so they are definitely going to use that advantage. They're going to go for power, beginning from the service zone. And that's why the first serve is very, very important, because usually that dictates the tempo of your game. For Thailand, well, their strength really is speed and their ability to ensure that that ball doesn't hit the floor. So it's going to be a tough decision, you know, who's going to win, but it all boils down to the mindset of both teams.
Our referee is Nahoko Watanabe, the first referee, the woman in the perch up there. And Xu Yute of Chinese Taipei is the man downstairs, our second referee. We are underway with this battle for third, the bronze medal battle, and the first point belongs to Thailand.
And that hit is always given by Ponpun. Usually the first play really goes to Jutarat. Her hit went in between those blockers, something that the blockers of Kazakhstan should watch out for.
Jutarat Montibilia all are taking care of, and there's a mess up on the back row.
Yeah, because when you move, a slight movement will cause your partner or your teammate to think that you're going to get the ball. At that particular time, Olga Biryakova thought that she was near the end line.
And a quick attack that is considered outside, and it is now 3-0 in favor of the Thais.
Yes, the hit of Kristina Anikonova was just an inch away from the sideline.
Here's Ngoc. Rare for a Thai name to be so short. In the meantime, that is down and out.
With Olga Biryakova, when she goes up for that hit, you have to really be careful with her, because she's been raking in the points for the Kazakhstan ever, you know, from the last two games.
Biryakova with the serve. Here's the set, the dink. Kept in play. The attack. Spellman. Jousted the net, alive and well. Here comes the attack. Matviana. And it is long and out.
Frazier tried to go above the blockers, yeah, because the blockers are tall, but it just went wide.
Ashley Fraser. It seems that most teams do have an import that they want to rely on. In the meantime, that is scored. Fraser knocking that down.
Yeah, that was a good comeback there from Fraser.
Filipino crowd trying to pick on somebody that they can cheer for here. Photon Philippines already done with its match, picking up seventh place. That is inside.
That was Haley Spellman. All 6-6 of her.
And wearing jersey number one. And when she's in the front, good things usually happen for Kazakhstan. It's 3-4 in favor of the Thais. But the three serving against Forna. Anikonova. Cracked down this time by Lukmokskaya. Ooh, look at that set. That's inside.
Yeah. Thai team, when they have a good first ball, they usually give it to the middle. And why not? If Plumjit is there, usually when she gets that quick play, she brings in the point.
Serve number 16, Ashley Fraser.
Fraser, jump serve in play. Almost an ace. There it is.
As it is.
You know, a jump serve does not have an arc. So when it travels, it's really fast and it's really powerful.
Again, Fraser at the service area. Her team ahead 6-3. She seems confident with that serve. Kept in play. The attack from the other end. Anna Kolova. There's a whistle. The Japanese referee says...
net violation.
Yeah.
That one was on Spellman.
So Fraser stays there. It is 7-3.
What a serve.
And out of play. It is now 8-3. We hit the first technical timeout. Thailand Bangkok Glass in charge of this match. Here's a second look at what Ashley has been doing. That serve is really filled with power and making it difficult to field. And she continues to do so. It's out of control as far as the digging on the other side is concerned.
You know, in the last games, Ashley would jump serve for like one or two times and the opponent wouldn't be able to get it, and then she'd make an error. But this time she's been doing a great job from the service zone.
Kazakhstan will use a timeout and most likely will talk about the serve of Ashley Fraser. Okay. 9-3 is the count here. It is Thailand Bangkok Glass in full command of this match so far in its first set.
You know, it seems like the tempo for both teams are not established yet, because it's like they're still feeling each other as to the game plan of one and the other. So now let's see how Kazakhstan would play out from the service of Spellman.
Spellman serving at 4-9. Yep, they go to the middle. They go to the middle and then take it from there. It's like opening a flower.
Right. A good combination play there. Look at the blockers. They were confused as to who was going to hit that ball. Was it going to be Plumjit or Willavan?
Now serving, number five, team captain, Plumjit Dinkau.
Exchange of dinks. Oh, there's a net touch.
Net violation.
It is 5-10 as the serve will go to Anar Kulova.
Serving number two, Sana Anar Kulova.
Sana Anar Kulova. 6 feet on the average, as you said. In the meantime, that is long. And it is now 5-11.
Service long. Point four.
Can't afford to have too many mistakes against Thailand.
That's right, because they're already leading, and you're just giving them the momentum.
Too many points being given away.
Yes.
As gifts. Nice set. Kept in play. Too close to the net. They'll make do, and they still score.
See, that's what I'm saying about the Thai team. They find ways to bring up the ball. For instance, that first ball was quite close, see, to the net, but Punpun managed to put that up for Jutarat to hit the ball and have a good finish.
Jutarat Montepila taking care of business there, and it's now 12-5. Thailand in charge from the back row, and they produce a point. Not the problem that time for Spellman.
Spellman there using her height from the back row. So even if it's far from the net, well, the angle of that hit just proved difficult for Thai.
Safronova with a serve. Whoa!
That's what you call skill from Apinyapong Willavan. There's that back set, single blocker. She saw that she could go cross-court hit with that play, and she did.
Willavan Apinapayong. Decision by Spellman to just toss it over, didn't gamble. That's a dink. Nope, it went under already.
But that was a good effort there from Olga Biryukova.
And the Kazakh side will take another timeout. Currently down 6-14.
But you must come every ball. But 1, 2, 3. This position service, your chance we do something. How is we do service? I inside? She's the show. How is we close after that? There you come. What do you do inside? I don't understand. Please. Good serve, I want. I don't want bad service. Who is trying good serve? Go out. Bye. Bye. They do show. They do show. Play inside.
Come on, come on.
Body language seems to say that it's getting to be too easy for the Thai side to get their scoring going. Plus, the contributions of this lady with her serve, she has simply been a cannon to work with. That's into the net. Wasted serve that time by Willavan Apiapong.
Serving for IBC, number 9, Rina Lukumskaya.
Lukumskaya all set to serve. Oh, I thought nobody would go for it. And that is Fraser.
Fraser with an off-the-block hit there. You know, Fraser was an All-American selection finalist for excellence for both on and off the court. And you know what her degree is in college?
Idea. What?
She had a 3.9 GPA for business administration, major in management and marketing.
Wow.
Yeah, smart.
And had time to study and play volleyball as well.
Yeah.
In the meantime, that was delivered upon by Biryukova. Thailand is just so disciplined when they play. The first ball is handled so well. We'll talk more about that when we return. It is 16-8 Bangkok Glass. we were talking about how disciplined the game of Thailand can be. And, you know, when your first ball is well-placed and delivered to the setter properly, good things happen for you.
Yeah, the setter doesn't need to run around the court trying to save it. More often than not, the players give the ball to Punpun. And that's why she's able to call different kinds of plays for them.
Yutarat Montepilla will serve. And even their serve is so disciplined, and that will stay down.
That ball got caught in the net. So there was a slight change in direction and speed.
As delivered by number 18, Aniknova. Aniknova. Her first name is simple and easy. Christina Aniknova. The attack in play. And a counterattack finds its way home. And that was well set by Lukovskaya.
And Beryukova just really avoided the blockers. You've got two blockers in the middle. She redirected that ball, angled it to zone 5, and that gave them the point.
It is 10-16. Aniknova. The quick. Alive, but not for long. You know, when the Thais suddenly feel they're getting bored with the game, they'll come up with a combination that finds its way to score.
And it's just really a perfect back set to Plumjit. The blockers of the Kazakhs were really separated. That's why the ball of Plumjit was able to easily go through them.
Number 5, Plumjit Tinkal, taking the upper hand now. Is still Thailand at 17-10. That's long.
Yeah, at that time, Montepilla tried to avoid their libero because she went to die for that ball, and maybe that's the reason why, you know, the adjustment was made at the last minute, so the ball flew out.
Tikapor Tinkao is such a fast-moving libero for Thailand.
Mm-hmm.
And now the serve will belong to number 6.
Number 6, Rimerly Santos Perez.
Filipina, siguro to. She might be Filipino. She has a Santos Perez name. Or she might be Latin American in ethnic origin. In the meantime, it is 17-12.
Yes, Santos Perez, Ray Merrily, is one of the imports, one of the three imports of the Kazakhs.
Sounds like the name of a good doctor. You're going to have yourselves checked up by Dr. Santos Perez. 12-17. Ashley. The set. Nice ding. But kept in play by Santos Perez. From the middle. Beryukova.
And you know, the good thing about the Kazakhs is they move their sets. They distribute it around so that you're left guessing as to who's going to hit the ball next.
If the Kazakhs start getting warmed up here, the Thais could be in for an interesting set. We have a timeout, but let's listen in if we can. Back on glass of Thailand, still ahead here in the first set, 17-13, battle for the bronze medal in the Asian Women's Club Championship here in Binan Laguna, the Philippines.
Santos Perez
will be serving. Her team currently down 13-17 here in the first. Fraser. The attack. Cracked down by Matvieva. And the libero of Thailand gets to it. Misset a bit there, but they made do. That is scored upon cleanly by Matvieva.
Matvieva really timed her jump. There was a high ball there. She didn't jump right away, timed it, angled her hit. There was no blocker for her. Good point.
Ina Matvieva. 14-17. I'll take of Kazakhstan knocking at the door. And that is inside. Not a problem on the cross-court hit by Willavan Apiñapong.
Willivan was named MVP in one of the AVCs before. And you know that she's got those angled hits up her sleeve. So whether there's a big blocker in front of her, it really wouldn't be a problem for her.
And it's hard to detect where direction she's going with the way she's cleared for the shot. Here's a dink. The power tip is played out. Ina Matveyeva.
Matveyeva's arm swing was so fast that the ball just had to... Look at this. There goes that setup. Single blocker. Went for down the line since the cross court was totally blocked by Ponpun.
You know, Ina Matveyeva did not start in today's match, but has been a factor coming off the bench. Fraser. Oh, no problem that time. Clean by Apinya Pong.
That's what I'm saying with Willivan. There goes that. That was a good dig there by Fraser. And when she hit that ball, it was just angled again because the two blockers were in front of her.
Please turn off the flash on your cell phone. The guy up the bleachers, thank you.
15 or 19-15 is the current count. Ina again. They're going to her almost exclusively now. The block almost kept in play, but no direction on the second dig.
You know, that save from coming from a touch from the block, it was a bit slow coming from Olga, so she has to move a little bit faster.
Pornpun Gephard, her serving play. Oh!
That was a good retort coming from an error.
And it is 16-20. Still within striking distance is Kazakhstan. Safronova.
Alicia Safronova.
Kept in play by Safronova. Ina. And that is outside. I told you she's been making things happen ever since she came off the bench. That's Ina Matveyeva.
Ina Matveyeva is probably the most mature player in the court today at 38 years old.
Safronova. You know, the variety in which Thailand is coming up with their sets, they're hitting in every direction. Nice set. That is blocked, though. And the blocking of Kazakhstan beginning to come intact here.
Yeah, when you go up against the wall, because, you know, not only are they tall, they know how to perfectly time a block. They don't just jump up, but they have that proper timing. So you have to go around those blockers and don't challenge them directly.
Safronova. Safronova again. From the back row we go. Chang Kao keeping it in play. The reverse. Oh! Yes, they'll call it clean. Looked like a bit of an overreach, but they call it clean.
And Diryukova, after that tip, look at that. She tips it right down. Looks a little bit at Willivan.
And as if she's avoiding the net, but that's a lot more body language on that one than we can see. Timeout taken. Close and tight in this first set, Kazakhstan breathing down the neck. And the next of Bangkok Glass of Thailand, battle for third here in the Asian Women's Club Championship in Binyan Laguna. Number 14, Safronova will continue to serve. Alicia. Ooh, messed up reception there. The set did not go through. That was too tight to begin with. Santos Perez had a difficult time in that set there.
That was full force from Mokwa. In that block, she read who the attacker was going to be and timed it perfectly.
My feeling is Ngoc might, her origins might be from Vietnam, really.
Yes, she is the import of Thailand from Vietnam. She looks it.
Yep, and the name seems to give her away in that regard as well. Some changes being made. The other libero of Kazakhstan will see action. That's Izao, replacing the other libero who has done her job as well. The other libero was Sadyukova. So look at this. It's 20 to 21. Lukskaya with her serve. Rigano! And that is a gift.
And you know, it almost was kept alive by the foot of one of the players of the Thai team, but it went straight to the net.
I have to forgive the use of the Filipino term, because when you say regalo, it's a gift. It's almost like a gift, really. Look at it. And the serve by Lukomskaya. The set. Oh! Ashley Fraser finding a way to score and getting her team out of trouble there.
Yeah, that was something that is badly needed by the Thai team. There goes that hit. She went for a cross court because it was just wide open. No blockers there.
Here's Ngoc with her serve. Bit of an overset. Oh, yes, sir! No problem that time for Biryukova.
Heated that hit by Biryukova.
And Olga using full extension to tie up this set at 22.
Now serving number three, Olga Biryukova.
Here comes Olga's serve. Fenkao gets to it, to the other side. That is caught in the water.
No coverage there for the Thai team. That was a wall right there.
And better blocking now by Kazakhstan. You pointed it out at the start of the coverage that this is one of the strengths of their game. Biryukova, Olga Biryukova will serve. Oh, too hot to handle. Too hot to handle, and look at this. Kazakhstan is at set point.
That was a good run there from the libero, Tikapon, but, you know, with all the effort, it was just the service of Olga Biryukova just proved to be really, really strong. Look at how she tried to save it.
And swinging back to live action, the serve of Olga is still in play. There's a push. Chenkao gets to it. Fraser. Better defense by Kazakhstan now. Set up job. It will stay down. And Kazakhstan coming from behind to take the first set, 25-22. May have happened that Thailand just relaxed a bit too early, Chiki.
Yeah, I think they were very quiet. It wasn't the normal Thai team that you would see in an opening set. But maybe we'll see a different Thai team in the second set.
And the first set going the way of Kazakhstan, Altay BC, 25-22.
from the Kazakhs, not allowing the hard-hitting balls of the Thai team to penetrate into their court. As you can see, there were good setups there. Olga Biryukova did a fantastic job for her team, allowing them to catch up to the Thai team. All those angled hits, and some were even helped by the net, proved to be very difficult for the floor defense of Thailand to keep alive, to keep that ball alive. And there you see the blocking. Kazakhstan is up by 2 points. Attacks, not much difference there, but look at the errors. They have kept it to a minimum. Kazakhstan only 3 and Thailand 6. This is not really normal for Thailand, because normally Thailand's errors does not go above 4 points. So to have them at 6 means that the Kazakhs really prepared. They had a lot of plays that forced the Thai team to commit those errors.
It seemed that Thailand was in control of that opening set, but it would not be so. Kazakhstan just held steady, and I think one of the key factors, of course, was when Olga took care of the serve, and so many other players just came to the fore to be able to keep the team in business. Olga Biryukova wearing number 3 for the Kazakhstan Altai BC.
There's Irina Lukomskaya, the setter of Kazakhstan.
And she did a very good job of distributing the leather to her teammates. I think Thailand fell into a strong sense of security in that set. And they thought they had the set already, but Kazakhstan had other ideas.
And now look who's going to serve. And Ashley Frazier.
Let's see if they can get her team off to a good start. Oh, and they do.
Her services, her balls are just really so fast that maybe when you're inside the court, you would hardly see the ball get in.
I agree. And there is a tendency, there's fear in your hearts right away. And you see the ball being tossed, and Olga says, "I'm not afraid." Olga is blocked, and it is 2-0. Biryukova all dressed up and nowhere to go.
Full force in that net with Plumjit and Ponpun blocking the hit of Olga. Even with that much power in her arms, couldn't do anything with that block.
And Frazier is still serving. Third serve by Frazier. Olga keeping it in play. Nicely done. They got on top of the set there. Anikonova, no problem that time. Christina going full extension there.
You know, Christina Anikonova didn't really hit that ball hard.
Yes,
and
I
the
agree.
Defense of the Thai team really backed up because they thought she was going to hit it hard. And then suddenly she changes her mind and puts it to zone 6.
This serve is out of the control. And Lukomskaya wasting the serve. It is 3-1 in favor of Bangkok Glass.
Nuchithik now serving for Thailand.
To Jamit Tengkal, and that'll go inside.
A good reaction there by Willavan. Apinyapong saw that ball was ripe for the picking, hits it hard, earns the point.
More service duties for Plumjit Tengkal. Set up Jalumuskaya. Oh, full extension, not exactly hardly hit, but just enough to create the point.
That's right. And in that last play, the service was given to Olga Biryukova, but no problem. She was ready to hit that ball.
Tengkal. That is outside.
It was way wide by Willavan. She was trying to avoid the blockers.
You know, the Thai players are a bit like the Filipino players. They also, it's gigil. The word there is gigil. And they get to be overexcited over wanting to score. This is a bit messed up, and it is.
And you know, the Kazakhs, they've been doing this in their past games, scoring from service zone. They attack from the service zone. And that's good because you give your teammates time to rest a little bit.
Popcorn Gedar asking for a better set from her teammates, and she helps create it. You know what I like about the setter of Thailand, that's number 11, Pornporn, get parked. She contorts her body in such a way you don't know where she's going, actually.
That's right. And in that last play, Mokwa was the one who finished it with a tip.
She doesn't go straight up. She twists her body at the last moment. Oh, it's up in the air. No problem that time. And Rukova, her shot muzzled. Olga, it becomes a set for Anulkova. Better volleyball here in the second set. Olga Chenkao reached four. And this is the longest exchange. Not, oh, it's outside.
I thought that ball did not really hit the palm of...
It sounded that way,
no? Yeah, of Haley Spellman's hand.
And that's why she ended up out of control.
Right.
She wanted to risk it to go down the line. Oh, right down the middle. No problem that time for Aranak Lukova.
And you know, that's something that is not normal for the Thai team to do, which is just to watch the ball fall on their side of the floor.
I agree. You know, for the Thai teams that we have observed, they always die for every ball.
Right.
It's a matter of life or death. And it's now Kazakhstan just an inch closer, but they waste the serve. It's 7-5, Bangkok Glass.
Good eye there from Frazier, not trying to get that ball anymore.
Good serve. Lumoskaya. Oh!
You could see her form when she went up for that hit. It was just textbook. Look at this. One, two, up, hits that ball, no blockers. The Thai team are just confused as to who the next attacker was going to be.
Haley's Comet going straight and true there.
That's right.
Down the middle we go. Kept in play by Ezal, and that is inside, and Kazakhstan is all business here, tying up the second set.
That ball rolled on the net. That's why it was difficult for the Thai team to figure out where it was going to land.
So Spellman will still be serving, a chance to grab the lead before the technical timeout, but wastes the serve. And Thailand has its heads above the surface as we hit the first technical timeout of set number two. The whole gamut of emotions of a sporting competition being unfurled on your screens. We hope you're enjoying the action. This is emanating from the Asian Women's Club Championship in Buñan Laguna, the Philippines. 8-7 is the count. This is the battle for the bronze medal. Last day of competition, the serve in play. Kazakhstan, Alt-ABC, the team on the right of your picture against Bangkok Glass of Thailand to the left. In play. Spellman, yes sir.
Haley's Comet right there. That was a good call. Yeah.
She gets a little more height as well.
Right. And her arm swing is so fast. That's why
good
the ball
yes.
goes really fast and really hard.
When she's trying to squeeze the trigger, she's fully loaded, but the serve is wasted.
Two service errors at my count in this set.
Sadjukova is the other libero for Kazakhstan. She alternates with number 10, that's Izao. Close battle at the net, kept in play by Gepard. The strike by Frazier.
And Frazier takes her third, hitting that ball hard. That was a difficult angle. It almost seemed like a cut shot.
serving number one. In the future, more volleyball players will be this tall. They'll get taller and taller as the generations continue to evolve. In the meantime, there's out of reach. It is now 9-10 in favor of still Thailand, but Kazakhstan will obtain the serve.
Look at Olga go. And she's in front, so your blockers have to be on their toes.
She's long.
Yes.
Out of reach. Faulty reception by Thailand, which is where Maliwan Pamplonaudong messing that up.
Because the services of the Kazakhs team is really loaded. It's not just coming from one player, but it's like the entire team has that technique that you score from the service zone.
Nicely done. Nicely done.
And you can see the expression on Plumjit's face. That was enough. She wanted to get the point for her team.
Plumjit and Kao says, thank you. Got it right in the bottom there.
Number 16, Ashley Fraser.
Fraser is back to where she began. Nice touch. Nice reach. Chen Kao. Joust at the net, and that's inside. It is tied at 11.
Yeah, the blockers were there, ready for that, because it was a difficult first ball, nowhere else to go but to the open. And it was even a little bit close to the net. That's why it was easy for the Kazakhs blockers to get that ball.
I like your point. There was really nowhere to go. The entire building was locked up together, nowhere to enter. Repeat of that same play. No dice on this one. This one is perfect. No problem for Olga Biryokova.
And it was a smart move, too, because Pun Pun was a smaller blocker. That's where she put the ball for an easy point.
But you like what Pun Pun Gephardt is doing right now. She's talking to her teammates. Hey, right on my back. We are going somewhere here. Stay steady. Ooh, Chen Kao. Is she still alive after that? I think she is. That was standing in the path of power. And that is what the libero's work did to her teammates, inspiring her teammates to play defense as well.
You know, Lubovskaya has been going to Olga almost all the time, and that's why the defense of Thailand knows already where the next ball is going to be given to.
And they knew exactly where she was going to go.
That's right.
Up, messed up. Olga Vuznakoya, unable to, Biryokova, unable to handle it. 13-12. Benjamin Chen Kao. Lumuskaya. Fraser digging it up. To the other end we go. Stays down.
Even if you've got two tall blockers in front of Willavan, she went to a down-the-line hit.
And it is a two-point lead for Bangkok Glass. Muskaya setting up. Net touch. Goodbye, Thailand. Making it a 13-14 second set. She just joined us. First set going the way of Kazakhstan, 25-22.
Serving for Kazakhstan.
Close to the net we go. That is rejected. Recoils. Joust. And a point for Thailand.
Again now. Willavan, when the ball is given to her, she finds ways and means to get that ball over despite the tall blockers.
Number 11, Pun Pun
Gephardt will be serving his tireless setter. Nice dig. Ooh, looked like a clean set, but that was misjudged by Arnokova. And that'll stay down though.
That was full force on the net there by the Kazakhs. I mean, you could see their hands are way above the net, and it seemed like they were reaching for the ball across the net, and that's really how you should be blocking.
Well, if you're playing against the Kazakhs, you better bring your A game. This is such a tall piece to spike against. taking care of business edge. A two-point lead for Thailand in the second set. We are at the second technical timeout.
You know, Willevan was even under the ball when she hit that, but she had good plans. She placed it well. Kazakhs weren't able to get it.
You know what I like about the Thais is that they're very athletic.
Mm-hmm.
It looks like they're strong women, that they will be inflexible, but they're strong. Look at that.
That's a good ball hitting the foot of Ponpun.
Yeah, you can use every body part.
Yeah.
Up. Net. Yep, yep. Ngoc didn't realize it. She was backing up. She had hit the net.
She has to be more careful because she's been hitting that net a lot of times already.
Number 16 is back in the match. That's Matveyeva. That's Ina Matveyeva. She produced 2 to 3 points in that first set, which enabled Kazakhstan to conquer that first set 25 to 22. Down the middle we go!
That was Maliwan Prabnarong. What a good set.
And the libero, Chenka was also delighted over it because she had helped create that play.
Right. She gave that ball right to Ponpun.
Middle attack.
That was a smart reply there from Olga.
You know, if you watch volleyball very closely, it approximates any martial art you can think of. It's almost like a boxing match, both fighters slugging at each other here.
That's right.
And with the sounds emanating from the spikes, you can feel as if they're throwing blows at each other. Oh, will they call it? No, they won't. Thailand hoping for an overreach there. The Japanese referee says, go away. Domo, I got it. Go away. Thank you.
Pumjit was saying that there was a net touch.
And I think a bit of an overreach also. But no, the Japanese says, Japanese representative.
Yeah, I thought the ball was in the right plane, imaginary plane, but it was a free ball.
No, life was a way of equalizing. Like, they got this bad serve. It's now 18-17.
Yeah.
Thailand is worried because it could be a turning point. They don't want to be down 2-0.
That's right.
Lumuskaya has been doing a good job setting. That will not work.
And again, they go to Olga, who delivers.
Santos Perez also doing a good job as setter as well. That's a miss hit, but they'll take it.
Yeah, I was just going to say, it hardly hit the hand of Plumjit, but it did the job. She really targets zone 6 because there was a real big hole there.
She'll take it.
Yeah, she'll take it.
Here's Ashley. Ooh, facial. Counter hit that time by Anna Golova.
That was beautifully done there. Beautifully executed by the Thai team.
Watch it again.
You think it's legit, and then suddenly it's Willevan. So did you see those blockers were confused? They didn't know who to block.
They ended up jumping up and down with nowhere to go. It is 2018. A timeout has been taken.
Don't try excellence. Okay. We must do attack
4 and 2, 3, short player. Miliko, a good day. I hope, I believe she killed ball. Okay, good. Yes, relax the girl. Relax the girl. Important, very important time. B turn, B after 2-0 front. Girl. 2-0 front. Alright, I want extra blow. Okay.
2018, it is still close and tight. It's the same way in the first set, which ended at 25-22. Meanwhile, Fraser is replaced in the Thai lineup. It is Chulim who is entering the first time. Sudatha Chulim.
Yeah, I think that was a defensive effort there from Coach K, because Sudatha is a defense specialist.
And they get dividends out of that change, and she will continue to serve her team ahead. 21-18 to Olim. You know, volleyball is a tough game to master. So many skills to master. And that threw off the defense completely. Kazakhstan melting here.
You know, Sutada was in the U-23, under-23. And she was one of the key players there.
A joyful Thai team into its huddle, while Kazakhstan has this look of concern.
Very important time, 3 points. Five. But close that, after difficult on everything. First time you try, now you try. Jubilo comes in.
And we are under, oh, look at that. Right. Look at the exuberance.
Yeah. Just when she was put in place, you know, she performs. That's what you're supposed to do.
And so far, she's contributed 2 points.
Yes.
Coming off the bench, replacing Fraser. Anarkulova in the back row. Anarkulova again. Santos Perez. And Olga taking care of business there.
Substitutions.
Again, it's Olga who's delivering the point for the Kazakhs.
22-19 is the count here.
I do want to see some combination plays from the Kazakhstan team, because they do have good first balls.
They seem to be content. They like to go cross court. They like to go down the line, but have not done too many quicks this afternoon.
Yeah, that's true.
Depart. And a block! Solid!
The blocking of the Kazakhs are just so well placed. You're really going up against the wall. Just look at the arms. The arm extension. It's almost like a dance in the air. They don't touch the net. They extend their arms. Good job.
Wait a minute. Timeout was taken, and Thailand needs to talk things over. They'll be in the huddle. You know, this is being fought very fiercely, because, you know, you'd like to ride the airplane going home with a medal in your suitcase or on your neck going home, because, you know, if you're fourth place, then win the bronze medal. So Kazakhstan is away, long way off. Thailand is just nearby. So in the meantime, excellent reach that time by Anarkulova. Olga
again going in between those blockers, using her height, using her power. Look at the strength in that hit. Blockers were there. They were covering the cross court, but it was such an angled hit. Blockers were just no use.
22-21, Thailand though still in the lead. Gepard goes the other direction. You know, the smart thing by the Thais, they're trying to use a lot of different approaches. They send it to the other end. The blocks are there, but unable to handle it.
Yeah, the blockers of the Kazakhs were not deceived by the play called
That's
by
Podbud. That's what I wanted to say. That was better said. Because the blocker said, no way, we're not going with you. You can run all you want. We don't care. We know where this is going.
That's right.
Tied at 22. It goes over.
I'm pretty sure there was like her heartbeat stopped for a moment. And then suddenly the ball went in. Point
and
for them.
Thailand tried to manage the crisis they're in. They're down by one.
There goes the serve of Irina Lukovskaya that hit the net. They thought that it wasn't going to go in, and that's why it's very important that you don't have your back facing the net. You always have to look at the ball for moments like those.
Good part style is she likes to turn her back to the ball off the serve, actually. She turns right away. Bang. But she had no second ball to work with. That's and now right. Kazakhstan finds itself at set point.
And you know, the Kazakhs are really doing a good job earning the point from the service zone. So now the Thai team brings back Ashley Fraser.
Pulling out your limb, who had three service attempts. And now it is set point.
They need an attack from the back row, and that's why Ashley's back.
Nicely done.
But the team captain says, okay, I'll take this one.
Let's save one set point here.
The blockers of Kazakhstan weren't together at that time. That's why the ball of Plumjit sailed away.
In the air we go. Get hard. Blocked. Kazakhstan really relying on its blocking. It is there!
The blockers knew that the ball was going to go to Willa Van, and Willa Van, since she's faced with two big blockers, what do? She was in position. She couldn't adjust anymore. There goes her hit. So with two big blockers in front, just hit it as hard as you can, hoping that it would go off the block. But the blockers were just really consistent with how they blocked. I mean, nowhere else to go.
Nowhere to go for the all-dressed up Thais. It is 25-22, 25-23. Kazakhstan threatening to wrap up the bronze medal until Thailand comes up with a response.
Yeah.
caught.
You know, the Kazakhs team, they can read well. What they do is they watch Ponpun. They look at her shoulders. They check where is she facing, who is she looking at, and that's why they're able to read the play of Ponpun.
That's Ponpun Gidpar, the setter of Thailand. There she is. She goes the other direction. Oh, nicely done. That is cleanly done. That is a new face on the floor. That is number one, Maliwan Prabnarong. She actually saw brief action earlier.
Yes, she did. Her ball went in between the blockers. The blockers weren't deceived. They were right there, but the angle of Maliwan's hit was just right for that kind of block. Ooh, until, well, the momentum was just killed from that service error.
And Fraser lands it in the net. It is 2-1 here in the third set. Kazakhstan threatening to shut out Bangkok Glass of Thailand. The reverse. Yes.
When Team Ngokwa has been quiet in the past sets, in the last game, she's been, you know, she's always one of the highest pointers, but now she's quiet. So let's see if we can see more action from her.
Her serve in play. Ooh, messed up that time by Sadjukova.
There you go, making herself known. She's in the ball game.
Aliya Sadjukova bungling that. It is now 3-2. The problem is Bangkok Glass will lead, but Kazakhstan knows how to play the end game. They managed to squeeze out wins in the first two sets. Nicely done. Cleanly done by Anar Kulova.
And I think they heard us when he said, we want to see some combination plays. There's one.
And Sana Anar Kulova taking care of tying the count at three.
Christina Anikonova serving.
Anikonova serves. Nice from the back row.
Nice combination play there as well from the Thai team. Again, that was a good finish by Willavan.
Willavan Apinapayong.
Anyone now serving?
Kept in play. Free ball. Nice move off the center. Stutter step, a bit of a fake. No problem for Fraser. Miss. Not good eye contact between setter and spiker there. Fraser keeping it in play. Reverse set. Lumjit. This will stay down.
And right there, Lumjit, when she hit that last ball, she was off position. That's why she's a little bit under, and that ball just, you know, was very easy for Lukomskaya to receive. And because there was a good setup from Lukomskaya, well, they knew how to finish.
Kazakhs asking about the service rotation. You can do that.
Yes, you can.
If you're not sure about it, you can ask all the time. It's a mistake the refs allow you to correct by asking and not calling it right away. Whoa, 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 whoa.
Willavan with a sharp down the line hit. I think there was only one blocker there for her, so she took advantage of that.
Willavan Apinyapong. The dink. It's still alive. Back row. Oh, out of reach. Can you imagine how much the drill, how many drills the Kazakhs do? They're so tall, they have to stoop down low to dig. That's not easy for tall people.
Oh, that's not easy. That's painful on the thighs.
And in the future, your lower back will charge you for it.
Yeah.
We're tied at five.
Again, Willavan with an in-between the blocks. A while ago, she was always blocked by the Kazakhs, but now she has found her groove.
She knows how to find those little crevices, those little spaces.
She saw that the blockers had a big gap in between them, so she took advantage of that.
6-5. Hello, full extension.
Olga Biryukova is only 22 years old. Just imagine all 6'3" of her. What a swing. And the blockers really could not do anything about that. She uses her height and fierce power. But then momentum was stopped there.
Reality comes back.
Yeah.
Won't you? And it is 6-7, 7-6, as Thailand will obtain the serve. Gepard. That in play. That is in play. Countermeasure, countermeasure against each other. The Thais winning out. It's 8-6. They are into the technical timeout ahead, 8-6. Back with us here at the 2016 Asian Women's Club Championship in Binyan, Laguna, the Philippines. Sam Sarmenta and Jiggy Pablo doing this for you. And this is the battle for the bronze medal. Kazakhs playing well, leading in the set count, 2-0.
11,
Gepard serving. Boy, the Kazakhs' confidence is growing with every passing point.
That's right, and why not? They've got two sets up, and now they are slowly catching up to the Thai team.
This has been the trend of the match. The Thais will lead it, and then suddenly the Kazakhs get their bearings. Lukomskaya serve, and Fraser, that shot is out. Oh, they correct it. They correct it. It is inside. It is overruled. The Japanese referee, first referee, says it is
inside.
Yes, it is Thai's point and serve. 9-7. Fraser will be serving. Here we go again. Cannonball.
Good save.
Ah! Outside. Kazakhs trying to pull a fast one by working the angles there, but they've fallen behind by three here.
Receive good attack, good service, please. Number one, L time wait, court side. She is up zone. After we win this set, she is up zone, good serve, okay?
We got you!
In that timeout, Coach Kanbulat said that, please, you know, really appealing to the team, do not touch the net, have some good services, just get rid of the service, kill this one by having a good first ball and a good attack so that Frazier can rotate. And that's exactly what they did.
That ball ricocheted so powerfully. I thought it'd go up to here in the upper box section where we are. It is now 8-10. Kazakhs still playing catch-up, and they will continue to play catch-up here.
Coach Kanbulat isn't really happy with that long ball.
Coach Burhan Saik Kanbulat of Kazakhstan. Ah, Thais bearings getting to be a little more together here.
Yeah, the first ball proved to be very difficult for Kazakhstan. That it had a misreceive. It went over the net, and Plumjit's there, so you wouldn't want that repeated.
I wonder if the Kazakhs still have that comeback quality here in this third set. Nice use of the elbow.
Good save.
Yes, indeed. Lumaskaya. Excellent saving by both. That's out.
That's what you call gigil in Tagalog.
Yeah, it was over anxiousness. It is now 9-12 as Kazakhstan will obtain the serve. All set to serve will be Annie Konova.
Christina Annie Konova now serving.
In play. Close to the net. They have to lift it up. Free ball. They're hoping for four touches, but yeah, they'll get it the other way.
I thought that was four touches. Punpun with that setup goes to Maliwan. No blockers in front of her, and she just loved that.
Close to the net. That is jam!
They read that well. The Kazakhs read that last play of the Thai team very well.
And they knew that Gepard would suddenly be a striker rather than a setter.
You know, these teams, they scout each other. So whenever Punpun gets a first ball, she's going to get that set up.
Serving number six, Rimerly Santos Perez.
Santos Perez in her serve.
Good first ball.
Combination played by Thailand. Arnold Kulova's shot being played out. Lifted into the air by Matyeva. Kept in play. But wait.
Net violation.
Yeah, there was a net violation, and I'm pretty sure Coach Kanbulat is going to call for a timeout soon, because he just said in the last timeout, no net touches, sure services, and it's not being played here by the Kazakhs.
Ina. Razor. Out of reach, out of play.
That was a no-look hit there from Frazier. She was facing cross-court and then suddenly tips that ball over to zone one for a down-the-line. Look at this.
I think Coach Kanbulat is just waiting for the technical timeout to be called.
That's right.
Rather than wasting the timeout. Mm-hmm. Ina. She's getting muzzled now. She's getting neutralized by the Thai defense. And she is again. Ina Matveeva, nowhere to go. Kazakhstan below. At this point, 16-10. Technical timeout. To 10 here in the third set. Thailand now leads.
And I'm pretty sure the Thai team would want to get this set, because if not, then the bronze medal goes to the Kazakhstan team.
Change in the lineup. It is number 16, Matveeva, who goes out. And Lukumskaya comes back in. Santos Perez also goes out. And Spellman is back in. They use a 9-woman rotation. About 9 or 10. Olga. Gepard to Fraser. Fraser says, let's recycle. That is caught.
Fast reflexes from the Kazakhs.
And they were on to what Gepard wanted to do.
That's right.
Gepard trying to pull a fast one there. 11-16 tally now. Anarkulova. Fraser. Dug up. No, not dug up.
With a fast play like that, it's really hard to block a Plumjit. There's that back set. She was running, and yet there was just a single blocker there.
And Plumjit and Kao has just made it 17-11. And she's serving. You know, that's what we call puto.
Yeah.
You keep it in play. Long. Kazakh showing a bit of frustration here.
But there was no wrist action there.
I agree.
In the hit of Olga Birdyukova.
18-11 count here. Timeout taken by Kazakhstan.
Maximum. Go, your shot, but we must turn court. Maybe we have one more set. We give and we want to take it. 24, but we said 24. Okay, now through try. Receive good, speak, don't stop. We are game, we are nation, don't stop. Okay?
Wake up, please. 18-11. Plumjit. Fraser jousting.
Wow, good effort there.
That could have been one more.
Yeah.
Could have been one more, but Sadjukova didn't lift it high enough.
Substitution for IBC Kazakhstan. Number 14 is out. Number 7. Ina German is in.
Ina German seeing action for the first time.
Mm-hmm.
Down the middle. German.
Ina German.
German with a performance right away there. As soon as she was brought in, brings in the point from that missed receive.
Current count is 12-19.
Now serving number 7, Ina German.
That is caught.
That was full force. The blockers of Kazakhstan, look at how their arms just went above as if they were going to reach out for that ball. And wow, that ball just had nowhere else to go.
All tentacles there. 13-19. German. It's inside. It's hands down.
You know, normally the Thai team would follow the ball until they were really sure if that ball was outside. But that particular time, they just watched it drop.
It is now 14-19. And swiftly, there's a reply.
Mokwa, she's 28 years old, and she's also a member of the Vietnam national team. In fact, she's the number one spiker of the national team.
Ngoc brings it over. Sadjukova keeping it in play. Oh, well done. Open spot.
That was a confusing play there from Ponpun. I mean, you could see the swells of the Kazakhs. They were just really tricked. See? They didn't know who. They thought it was Moko was going to hit the ball, and then suddenly it was Maliwan, and they were just too late for that.
They could not lift it up. Excellent connection by Haley Spellman. All set to serve. For all of us is Lukomskaya.
Lukomskaya is also a member of the Kazakhstan's national team.
Nowhere to go.
Olga, on the other hand, is not yet in the national team. So maybe, you know, after this performance.
Maybe. She has height, she has length.
Yes.
She has power, and it's a 5-point gap Kazakhstan is looking at. Lukomskaya kept in play. Ezau. That's rejected. Nowhere to go for Beer Yokova.
That was a good block because Maliwan Pradnarong is so much smaller than Olga, but she was able to stop her hit from entering their side of the court.
Fraser, long.
Ooh. Now they can breathe because they were really tensing up because it was Fraser who was going to serve that ball.
17-22. Buryakova, the push to the back row. That's a miss hit by Spellman.
Yeah, it seemed like the ball slipped on the fingers of Spellman. Mistimed her jump and her hit.
Thailand inching in closer to the finish line of this third set. Here's Ngoc. And she makes up for it.
Right away. There's that back set. No blockers there.
Power. Net touch. Net touch.
Yeah, I think that net touch was from Sana Anarkolova.
And it is now set point for Thailand. Set up job. Yes, neatly done. Anarkolova.
Yeah, that's her favorite spot, zone one, that area. Her hits are normally geared towards that area.
Saving one set point now. Combination. Does not go through. They put it away. Oh, she's caught with her hand in the cookie jar. She had the right thing in mind, but took her eye off the ball most likely. Yes, go ahead, please.
Thai team stays alive. That was an easy ball over. But there goes that setup. It was just too tempting for her not to do a tip over.
And Thailand takes the third set down 2-1 in the set count. More volleyball action in the Asian Women's Club Championship after this.
Think around me, oh, it fades away. I can't help but wonder how it got this way.
Coming out of the third set, which ended at 25-19 in favor of Bangkok Glass. Kazakhstan was not able to recover in the same way that they did in the first two sets, Jimmy.
Yes, Thailand had a better set this time, that more combination plays. They were able to control the services of the Kazakh team, and that enabled them to go to Bukjit, to go to Willaban, and Willaban also, and Mokwa as well. And Willaban, whenever the ball was given to her, she would find ways and means to go in between the blockers. And you see there, in that last play, Maliwan also did a good job answering those, or supporting those fast sets from Ponkun. This one also, what killed the Kazakhs in that particular set were all those net infractions,
yep,
and service errors. Yeah.
We'll see the numbers right now, and some standard errors.
That's right. Look at that. 7 as opposed to only 3. Again, this is the normal Thai errors.
Yep.
3 or 0. The attacks also, Thailand up by 4. But the blocking served well for Kazakhs. It's just that they need to get good first balls again to come up with those attacks, like what they did in the first set. If they want to take this third set, they got to go back to what they did in the first two sets.
And I think they need a point to start.
They've been blocked,
yep,
blocked by the Kazakhs. They find ways and means to get their balls through.
Underway, set number 4. Big shot by Spellman, neutralized. That is through Fraser.
That's a good start for the Thai team.
And we've got the serve now. Get parred. The setter. Nicely done.
That's a faster play. They need to have more of those fast plays so that they could get through or go through the blocks of the Thai team.
Kristina Anikonova taking care of equalizing the tally at 1 point apiece. Again, this is the battle for third in the Asian Women's Club Championship. That is clearly out of reach.
And Olga has been doing a good job at the service zone in the past sets. She's also gained some points from the service area.
Yes, indeed. Olga Beryokova.
Two serving one.
They go to Ashley Spellman. Get parred, keeping it in play. Mok. Spellman. Block. Third longest rally. Yes!
And that long rally was ended by Sana Anarkulova. She angled that hit. There was a blocker in front of her. But a single blocker is easy to avoid for a tall player like Sana Anarkulova.
3 serving one.
3-1. Sails done neatly. Dug up cleanly as well. Spellman gets it to roll in.
Did you see how Irina Lukomskaya just backset that ball, and it was so perfect? That was a good play.
Yes, indeed. 4-1, Kazakhstan coming out of the gates, charging strongly now. That is outside.
Yeah, that ball went wide.
Serving So serving, number three.
Kazakhstan, Altai BC, ahead by four, fourth set. Better back row digging now. Huliga, but out.
That's an off the block hit from Maliwan.
Was caught.
Big smile on her face.
Yeah, as we say, you're caught. But that was out of reach. Nice serve. Like a bullet coming out of a gun. The meantime, that's too long.
Yeah, there was an extra hop in her approach, in Haley's approach, and that probably caused the long ball.
Ashley Fraser serving.
Fraser to serve.
Good first ball.
Yes, by Sadjukova. Good part. A lot of jousting, battling at the net. Back row strike. Kept in the play.
Oh. You know what Winnevan did there? She just tapped that ball onto the hands of the blockers. It wasn't a strong hit. She played with the blockers. See, she just let that ball graze through the hands of the blockers with an angle.
4-5. Sadjukova handling it well. So does Ashley. Blocked. Kicked. Sadjukova circling down. It is out. We're tied at five.
This is a better ball game than the first three sets. I mean, now you can see everybody's now awake, doing a good job with those foot saves there.
And Sudjukova has been the target of Fraser. In the meantime, that is delivered upon by Spellman.
Spellman, that time when she hit that ball, you could see the frustration because she wasn't able to hit that ball as cleanly as she wanted to in the past setups, but that one really just made up for it.
6-5, that is outside. And some fatigue now beginning to creep in. Knock will serve at 6 apiece. Sadjukova. They not cross over.
You know, I really think fatigue is setting in because the Kazakhs have been receiving really strong balls from the Thai team, and that's not an easy thing to do.
Can't do it all afternoon long. Here's Ngoc.
Nice play there from Irina Lukovskaya. Spellman just came from nowhere.
Yep, indeed. And it is now all sewn up together at 7. Kazakhstan will serve. Spellman to do the honors. Easy going. Kept in play by Spellman. Runner inside.
And
number 14, Safronova scoring there. Timeout taken at It's the Technical Timeout.
All bad ball, where we put corner, please, little inside. They are kill, but clean pass, okay? Maybe don't come service. Clean do after they are killed, believe me. Open ball after they are difficult kill. They do good defense. Ball inside, they are block up zone, strong kill. Back ball, this is don't have chance, strong attack. After defense do clean. Please, she is now ready. She is now ready for attack. Please, clean pass. She 7번. 7번 나.
Well, Coach Kanbulat, in that last technical timeout, was saying we need a clean ball because Spellman is ready for those attacks. Well, even at the back, she can do an attack. And in front, well, you've got Safronova and Anarkulova. So big attackers. All they need are good, clean balls, first balls. But that's going to be very difficult whenever Plumjit takes the lead.
Plumjit Tingkao.
Nice. Look at that. The blockers weren't ready for her. It was such a fast play. Blockers weren't even ready.
Yes, and we are tied at 8. Push. That is too easy.
Yeah. Safronova, very smart move there. No need for hard hits when you can just tip that ball over for an easy point.
Alessia Safronova made it 9-8. Just above the net now. Push into the back row. Perfectly done.
Now this is going to be difficult for the Thai team because Olga is in front already. So you have to have those blocks set up for Olga.
And Olga Beryukova has given Kazakhstan Altay BC a 2-point lead. They lead in the set count 2-1. And
there's an overreaching there called on the Kazakhs.
Willivan with a serve.
Willivan serve. Back row. That is full extension.
Ooh.
That is short.
Her hand, yeah, her hand was a little bit low. That's why when she hit that ball, it went straight to the net.
And a 2-point lead just dissolves in a matter of moments. Nice push. Nice push. Smart play.
Again, Safronova really just seeing that hole in zone 4.
And they're back in front by 1. In play. Change of placement shot. No problem that time for the libero. Chankao, that's down.
You know, it was, you could see that Willivan was going to tip that ball over with her approach and the position of her hand, but it wasn't read well by the floor defense of the Kazakhs.
And we are tied at 11.
Now serving.
From Jitinkau. Crawls over the net and throws off the Kazakhs completely.
Nice. 12-11. Now there's a bit of a momentum here with
yes.
The Thai team.
From Jitinkau.
Still alive.
Yes, indeed. Tracked down nicely. Ashley's caught. They reverse it. That is not caught. Ngoc hiding the opening.
There was only one blocker there for Ngocwa. And when the back set came, the blocker was late. Olga was late.
And it was done so quickly, actually. Sometimes volleyball is not just power and strength. Yeah, some quickness has to be uncoiled as well.
Right.
From Jit. Blocked.
That was by Varbanova, Vanya Varbanova, one of the imports of the Kazakh team.
Yeah, her şey yapıyoruz ya. For don't win. We do everything don't win. We do everything. All stupid job. Yeah, little relax. Yeah, classic play. Normal receive. We play classic finish. We don't do stupid mistakes. Please, girls, normal play. Normal. I don't want extra. Please, through compass, through center, through to.
Hey, get a kick out of Buran Saik's Kanblat's attempts to speak in English.
Well, all he said there was go back to the basics, go back to the classic play, normal play, no need for extra.
No hanky-panky monkey business for this particular set because we're down 14 to 12 now.
And that last hit finished well by Varbanova from Bulgaria.
Lock reaching it over. Ezau keeping it in play from the back row.
A sharp hit from the back row by
Arkulova.
Yes, Arkulova.
And again, it's tightening up. Just a one-point lead for Bangkok Glass.
Sana Narkulova is also a member of the Kazakhstan's national team.
Nice reverse. Spellman kept in the air. They recycle. Gepard, knock.
That ball hit the antenna. That's why it was called out.
Looked clean though, but it is not going to be so. 15-13, Thailand threatening to equalize the count. And threatening again. 16-13, second technical timeout, Thailand ahead.
You've got Pon Poon Kudipard of the Thai team, who's been doing a fantastic job, not just from the service zone, but also in distributing the sets, coming up with those cross combination plays. And that's why they have taken the lead, 3 points up.
And her leadership has been most valuable.
Mm-hmm.
She's trying to calm down her team when they are in dire straits. Top set, open. It is 17-13.
That was just too easy for Wenti Ngokwa.
And Coach Kanbolat can't believe what he just saw. This should be interesting to listen to.
Why you don't see? Ya ne kadar aptalsınız siz ya? Ya we do mistake, they don't do nothing. We lost match, girls. Why don't try 6 and 4? Center player, you give pass. Yeah, every after timeout, I wait some salak mistake. Yok chance we win this position.
And that was a mouthful.
Yeah, because Coach Kanbulat could not believe what's happening. They easily got the first two sets. Talked about the Kazakhstan team. So and then suddenly now...
Why are we still here?
Right. They seem to be at a loss as to how to defend their zones.
Coach Fabio Menta of the Philippines said earlier, I don't want to stay on the court more than 1 hour. Let's get out of here. That's long. Thais were hoping for a check ball there, but no, won't be so.
Now serving, number 17, Vania Varbanova.
Varbanova. No. Yes, Al. Anarkulova. One-handed set!
It seemed really easy for Punpun to save that ball and put it up. You can just imagine the strong fingers that she has. Look at that. It was even perfect distance, perfect height for Ngokwa.
To say, so silly. Yours.
Yeah, there you go.
Yours.
Number 17 is now.
Giving it to you.
Number 17, Varbanova of Kazakhstan is out. Still close and tight, though. What Kazakhstan needs is to obtain the serve.
Good first ball there.
Yeah. Oh.
That's out. 19-14.
Yeah, that was really high. There was no touch there.
With Sadjokova, the libero of Kazakhstan, has had her share of punishment this afternoon.
Good setup.
Yes, they'll score out that.
That was a really good setup by Lukomskaya. She came from so far, and yet she was able to put that up just right for Sana Anarkulova.
And it's a 4-point.
Serving for Kazakhstan, number 18,
fourth
Kristina
set.
Anikanova.
Anikanova will be serving. Fraser. Gepard. That's blocked. The blocking also of Kazakhstan has sort of melted down as well. The attack. Yes. That is a big block. Look, celebrating.
The approach of Sana made the Thai team read the offense of the Kazakhs. And, you know, it was almost just a one-man set blocker there in Ngokwa.
Ngokwa Nguyen Thi, who, as you said, is the Vietnamese guest player.
Yes.
That served sharp. That's blocked. And it'll stay down. Anarkulova. Nobody picked her up for the prom.
It seemed like the Thai team knows exactly where Anarkulova is going to bring her ball. That's why they're able to cover that plane.
The defense has simply tightened up for Thailand. Here's Ngoc. Long. It's long. Was actually appealing her case. Some changes in the Kazakh lineup. German is in. So is Santos Perez. German, so brief action in the previous set. 21-16 tally here, fourth set. Good sized crowd to watch the volleyball action. But still, the gold medal match to be played. Featuring China and Japan.
That's going to be an exciting match to watch.
So rank number six, Santos Perez. As it is.
That is out of reach. They could not handle it. Maliwan and Chow Kao tried to track it down.
It's very difficult to receive a strong serve when you're receiving it sideways. You have to square your shoulders to the ball so that you could have full control.
To me, that kind of play was called best effort. Let's see if we can keep it in play. Oh, excellent digging by Santos Perez. In play, Chupai! Yes, sir!
When Plumjit hits that ball, she doesn't just bring the ball over. She looks for those zones that are difficult to receive. Look at that. That landed.
Yeah. Look at the hand action.
Yes.
She let her hand do the dialing, so to speak. 22-17. Santos Perez, the German.
And German putting that ball in between those blockers.
22-18, still not yet over.
Now serving, Sana Anarkulova.
Anarkulova to serve into the middle.
Plumjit has a performance of her life here from one point to another. I mean, now it's in a different location.
And Gepard knows it. She's going to Plumjit almost exclusively now. Tinka keeping it in play. That's missed. But they score!
They are going solely to Plumjit. I mean, now, even if she makes a mistake, her fingers are just so strong that when it hits the ball, it directs it to a zone that's empty. Look at that. No one right there. Santos Perez was late.
Thailand threatening to ice this at two sets apiece.
Plumjit again.
That push does not work. The strike. Kept in play. Chankov. Gepard tried to go to the open spot. German was there. Chankov. Push. This could take a while. Yes!
That was a tiring rally with all those hard-hitting balls. I mean, it's not easy to receive those kinds of balls.
And they may have paid a big price. One of the players just got injured on the Kazakh side, but the crowd enjoying this.
You can't afford to have Olga injured at a time like this.
Not now. Olga Biryakova may be a bit of cramps also. One set point has been saved. Plumjit gave it to Gepard. Too long. Two set points have been saved now.
Seems like Olga Biryakova is really hurt.
It's cramps now. Could be cramps. He's stiffening up. Concern on both sides of the floor. Two set points have now been saved by Kazakhstan.
We can hear the seventh man of Thailand. That's the crowd cheering them on.
Number three. Blocking of Kazakhstan suddenly made a return flight. Plumjit is caught.
And that was a relief for Kazakhstan, being able to block Plumjit.
Long, and that hurts. We are going into a fifth set.
It was a good fourth set. There were a lot of hard hits. There were a lot of plays that, you know, were just slow, aiming the open zones. But Plumjit did a fantastic job in the latter part.
Everybody, 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 ever
how both teams are going to face each other this time around. You can see in the court right now, the Kazakhs team are jumping. They're trying to get their energy level up.
Yep. And you know, I wouldn't be surprised. There's quite a large Thai community in the Philippines as well.
And a lot of fans for the Thai team. It's like what you said earlier, Seth. We always go to Thailand for tutorials, so to speak, for volleyball. And that's why the Thai is close to the heart of the Filipinos.
I mean, taking nothing away from Kazakhstan, that has showed some grit here, despite the fact that they lost their handle on the third and fourth sets. Let's get going. First serve of the fifth.
That's a quick point there from Ngokwa.
And you know, Ngok has played well in the fourth set straight into this fifth.
Now serving Ashley Fraser.
Here comes Fraser. Cannonball!
Oh! She targeted Sana Narkulova. Is she going to target her again? Does.
Top set. Excellently done by Lubskaya. Spellman. Rock is caught. Too many tentacles there. Net touch. Good. And it is 3-0.
Good blocking there from the Kazakhs. It's unfortunate that there was a net infraction.
You know, it's a psychological battle at this point. The Kazakhs are still thinking of the two-set lead that they lost. Now there's a timeout taken. Let's see if we can sneak in to the Kazakh timeout with Coach Kanbulat.
We have two corner weight attacks. Before height, we must do attack ready weight. Maybe out. I say directly back. Okay. Now one receive. Okay. Давай, must turn directly.
Давай. Сколько раз вы ждите подачи сложной?
Action resumes. Fraser wastes the serve.
That was a good timeout there by Coach Kanbulat.
That really has an effect on the rhythm of the server, especially with a cannonball serve like hers. 1-3. Fifth sets are never easy. You have to play good percentage volleyball and at the same time take a few risks. That's a joust. That's a risk.
Yeah, that was won by Spellman.
2-3 counts. Look at that. Excellent joust at the net. That's inside.
Nice angled hit there from Ngokwa. Did you see how she manipulated that ball, twisting her arm a little bit just to redirect the ball? There goes her approach, and there goes that twist of the arm.
And you know, Porn Get Pard is a ballet dancer in the air.
Right, very graceful.
She is not exactly svelte. She is a strong woman, but the way she contorts her body is a marvel to watch.
Now serving number 18, Christina Adikonova.
Yes! Whoa. Yes!
And that combination play has proved to be successful ever since the first, second sets.
Watch it.
they thought it was going to be Plumjit who was going to hit that ball because she was established, well established by Konpun.
Excellent point. That's why in your team you want everybody to be a threat. That's out of range. And Thailand now jumps in front by three.
Kazakhstan has to regroup. They have to be able to stop Maliwan's service.
Well done.
Safronova also with a little twist on her arm.
We have German coming back in, as well as number six, Santos Perez.
Santos Perez is in. Another substitution. Number nine is out. Number seven, Ina German, is in.
4-6. Santos Perez to serve. The referee from Chinese Taipei is a fast worker. He doesn't now wait too much time in seeing the rotation and seeing that the subs are properly filled up.
Cleanly done there by Willivan. The blockers were inside, so she put that ball at the side of the blockers, very well placed.
You know, just when you thought that you'd forgotten about Willivan, Willivan,
Apinyapong,
then suddenly she says, I'm here.
Yeah.
Oh!
And now you could see why this Thai team has been champions of the ABC in the past years. Their system is just working well for them.
And they were resilient.
Yes.
They did not succumb to the pressure of being down by two sets. They could have just folded up their tents, right, went home to Bangkok and said, sorry, didn't happen. But they said, let's crawl back.
That's right. Very resilient. Konpun doing a good job. Thai team there rejoicing because they hit eight first.
Apinyapong. German is caught!
No coverage there for the Kazakhs. A great block there. Block fast from Plumjit and Konpun.
And Thailand, back of glass, inching closer to the bronze medal. It didn't seem that way. Two sets back. And the meltdown just continues.
You know, this Thai team is really just piling on the pressure on the Kazakhs team.
Exactly. And it is now a six-point lead. Apinyapong has been there almost forever now. The grittiness, the edge, and the swagger of the Kazakhs disappeared after that third set, really.
That's right. You noticed that.
It seemed like they were on their way. Anyway, here comes an opportunity to roar back.
A lot of heat in that hit there from Safronova.
You know, Safronova, even in that set, that fourth set with which they lost, kept on plugging away, even if the boss was really out of reach. And it's a five-point lead now. Five serving against 10.
That wasn't very hard for Plumjit to do. In fact, it was fun. Look at that. Single blocker there. Took advantage of it. She had the height in her jump. And she put that ball in just when the blocker was on her way down.
Yeah, VC. 2-0 after VC. Salak, 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 stupid mistake. Everything we lost. More we lost. We are stupid play. We lost 2-0, lost 2-0 after stop. Everybody think match finished. Don't finish. Now again don't finish. Now match again don't finish.
Oh boy, this setter of Thailand just is so impressive.
And you know, she's not even the number one setter in Thailand.
Yeah. Born Punggit Park. I just like the way she's so creative.
Yes, indeed.
You have no idea where she's going.
Look at that save. Oh, wow. Even with that miss receive, an excellent save there by Willa Van. They made something out of that off receive. Look at that save. It goes up, giving Pon Pun time to set up a play, and they finish it well.
Veryakova is back in the match. Hold out Barbanova. Here's Punggit. Kept in play. Frazier.
Frazier was facing cross court, but she put that ball down the line. That's why the floor defense of Kazakhstan was late.
Thailand now 2 points away. That is going to bring them to match point.
It was well read by the blockers of Thailand that the ball was going to go to Spellman and she was going to come from the back line. So they were prepared when to go up for that block.
The serve. Ah, that could have been tracked down by Punggit, but she had her back turned to the ball.
Yeah, that was a good save by the foot of...
Yeah.
Was that Ashton Frazier's foot?
I think they were
no,
all...
No, it was Willavan's.
I think they were all surprised that the ball was still in...
Right.
In play. Yeah. Still at match point. That'll do it. That'll do it. Rather anticlimactic with all the power that was uncorked here today. But... That'll do it. Thailand, back of class, picking up third spot. It's so frustrating for Kazakhstan because they led practically all the way.
Yeah, the Thai team really just had their system in place. They did not panic. The first two sets were won by the Kazakhs team. They had the momentum coming into the third set. But the energy of the Thai team picked up in the last two sets. And, you know, slowly but surely, they just stole the energy from the Kazakhs team.
That's the best way to put it then. So many stars with this Thai battle class team. And their coaches did not give up on them as well. Huh?
Right. You know, all throughout the match, Coach K was very calm. It just goes to show you that he knows the capability of his team.
I take nothing away from this game, Kazakhstan team. And they gave it their all,
yes,
but was unable to deliver it in the end. There is the joyful Thai team celebrating.
You know, the Kazakhs team did a good job as well. I love the way they blocked those balls.
I agree.
And in the first two sets, they really performed very well, working as a team, working as one. It's just that in the third and the last onwards, the energy just was little by little eaten up by the Thai team.
And just a few more things to finish. We'll just take a look at the numbers, but still to come is the gold medal match involving China and Japan. No worries or no frustrations with the Thais. They'll go home with a medal, and there's something to be proud of for their club as well.
Yes, you see there, Maliwan did a great job. And in the beginning, Jutarat were breaking in all those points. But Pon Pun did a fantastic job distributing those sets, coming up with plays that were not predictable.
With that kind of music, I'm beginning to feel we're going to chill and party here. It's been a joyful tournament, and still so much more action to come. The championship gold medal battle still to be played out.
Yes, we do welcome tournaments like this because then we get to see how else the Philippine volleyball program can be improved with all the different techniques that we see from these different countries. And there in set five, the attacks of Thailand was just 5 points more than Kazakhstan. And look at the errors. Kazakhstan with one error and Thai team with two. But, you know, they had blocks more, they had services more, and Thailand just did an overall better job in that last set. In the match summary, the errors, well, 19 as opposed to 25. Attacks, not that much of a difference either, blocks. But all in all, when you total all those points that were gained by Thailand, that's the one that brought them the win.
The Thai team now thanking the audience that turned out to support them this afternoon. And so many highlights. We were treated to a display of power and a lot of guts and cannonball serves and big blocks. Everything you look for in a volleyball game, Chicky.
Yes, Plumjit was a turning point. I mean, with those consecutive A-quicks that she did in different locations, it wasn't just in one spot. It became very unpredictable for the Kazakhs to defend the ball. And then also the services from Plumjit. Those were powerful enough that it gave them the lead and it gave them the confidence and the momentum to finally finish the match.
Crowd relished every bit of action they saw from two very good teams. The Kazakh team took the early lead, two sets to nil, and then the third and fourth went the way of Thai Bangkok Glass. And in the fifth set, just a matter of time, Bangkok Glass took care of business and won the match 3-2. So just a few more highlights to unfurl, and this crowd is ready to just about party for the championship match. And with the way volleyball has exploded in the country, I'm sure Filipinos will be enjoying themselves with a great display of volleyball also, as Japan and China will battle for the gold medal. And that's the victorious bronze medal team. And Chicky, we'd like to thank everybody for joining us. Here's the final bracket and the battle for third, the win, of course, by Thailand.
Yes, it was an excellent play by both teams, Thailand and Kazakhstan. Great volleyball action enjoyed by everyone. All the players that were put inside the court, they contributed well for their team. It was just unfortunate that a team had to lose in the battle for third.
And in the spirit of sports, nobody loses. Thank you for joining us here at the 2016 Asian Women's Club Championship in Binyan, Laguna, the Philippines. Thank you. Mabuhay.